Okay, good morning to all of you. Today we are going to discuss somewhat rest of the part of the relativistic addition of velocities. These things we have been discussed in our last class in detail, and we found ux dash is equal to ux minus v by 1 minus v by c square ux. I have to quite zoom, then it will be better that you can read. U y dash equal to u y root over of 1 minus v square by c square whole divided by 1 minus v by c square u x, and u z dash, this is z, okay, z dash equal to u z into 1 minus v square by c square root over by 1 minus v by c square u x. So these are equation number 1, 2, 3, and another three equation we found. Whatever observed from the earth reference, that means from the stationary frame of reference, that is your ux equal to ux dash plus v by 1 plus v by c square ux dash, uy equal to uy dash into 1 minus v square by c square root over by 1 plus v by c square ux dash. Okay. And uz we found uz dash into 1 minus v square by c square root over whole divided by 1 plus v by c square ux dash. So this equation is called as 4, 5, and 6. So you just refer the last video of your relativistic addition of velocities. In that video in detail we have been derived this 6 equation. So here we are going to discuss somewhat extra things regarding this addition of velocity, that is your upper limit possible of the speed. That means is there is the speed more than light speed is possible or not, that we are going to be discuss. Before that, a interesting equation or things here you can observe, that you can see that in your equation number 14.46 and 14.47, that you can consider these the so-called 4, 5, 6, whatever we given. Either you have to consider these three equation or these three equation for velocity less than that of the c. Velocity, the particle is moving very less than that of the c. That means you can say your day-to-day life body is moving, which is very less than that of the light speed. Then if we have to consider this situation, then these additions or the relativistic addition of velocity will be looks like the Galilean transformation or Newtonian addition of velocity. How it is, you just see. Suppose we have to consider v is less than that of the c, so that v by c less than that of the 1. Okay, so wherever the v by c term we can found in these 6 equations, that can be neglected. So here we 3 equations we found. Here we have to consider ux dash, uy dash, uz dash. So ux dash, you consider ux dash. So ux dash, here v by c means can be neglected. Okay, so it will be considered as 0. So vx minus v by 1. So we can get ux minus v. So ux dash will be ux minus v. Ux dash equal to ux minus v. Then uy dash and uz dash, you just watch uy dash, that is 1 minus v square by c square. Here v by c is there, v by c can be neglected. So here 1 is there, 1 root over means 1, and here in the denominator v by c square is there, also can be neglected this term. So we found uy dash equal to uy. Likewise, we can found uz dash equal to uz. So what we found, that ux dash equal to ux minus v, uy dash equal to uy, uz dash equal to uz. So according to Newtonian mechanics, you just see that this particle velocity is u. Okay, this particle velocity is u, and this frame of reference is moving with velocity v, and here is the portion. Okay, if this portion is going to watch, what will be the speed of this one, this ball? It will be u minus v. Suppose u is greater than that of the v, and both u and v is very very less than that of the c. U and v is less than that of the c, then you can see that but u is greater than v. Here u is greater than v, that means this particle is just crossing this moving frame of reference. So the person who is sitting here, he is the person, can we observe the velocity of this particle will be u, that is velocity of the particle minus his speed. His speed means speed of this s dash, that is v, that person is going to measure, that the speed of this particle will be u minus v. Or you can say that from this frame of reference, the so called u x dash will be equal to u x minus v, whatever we found here. Okay, and obviously there is no moment along y axis and z axis, so u y dash equal to u y, u z dash will be equal to u z. You just write this much after this 6 equations. Now we have to consider or try to find out, is there any upper limit possible of the speed? That means, is there any speed possible which will be greater than that of the light speed? That we are going to be verify. It could not be possible. Suppose v by c is less than that of the c, and that implies ux dash. I told that here both ux and v both are less than that of the c. So v by c is less than that of the 1, ux dash by c also less than that of the 1. Then 1 minus v by c obviously greater than that of the 0, and 1 minus ux dash by c also greater than equal to 0. So by multiplying these two terms will be equal to or greater than that of the 0. Now you just multiply these two terms. What we can get? We can get 1 plus c v, this is minus plus v ux dash by c square minus v by c minus ux dash by c greater than that of the 0. Okay, so that implies 1 plus v by c square ux dash will be greater than that of the this one. You take these two terms to the right side, so it will be 1 by c ux dash plus v. Okay, so hence we can write, you take c to this side and this term to this side at the denominator. So it will be, it can be written as, that implies here c is greater than that of ux dash plus v by this much term, 1 plus v by c square into ux dash. Okay, or you can write in this way, that same thing it is written, ux dash plus v by 1 plus v by c square into ux dash is less than that of the c, or here we return c is greater than that of the this one, same thing. Or we can say that ux, here we consider that your v by c square is less than that of the 1. Here we consider v by c is less than that of the 1, so this term can be neglected. And here ux dash plus v, take v minus v this side, it will be ux dash plus v is equal to ux. So hence ux is less than that of the c. So here the velocity ux, that means the velocity of the particle, this demonstrates that the speed of the light in the vacuum is upper limit of the possible speed. That means whatever we are going to be speed consider, that may be ux dash or ux or v, is always be less than that of the c. Okay, now velocity addition formula for motion in one dimension, the same equation I just modified. this same equation I just modified, you just watch here. Suppose the motion of the object is parallel to the x-axis. In this case, uy dash uz dash not to be considered because there is no moment along x-axis, y-axis, or there is no velocity component along x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, sorry, y-axis and z-axis, so 0 and 0. Substitute ux dash equal to u, ux equal to u in equation number 47, means here we have to consider. So ux is considered as u, ux dash is considered as u dash. So it will be u x means u, ux dash means u dash. So it will be u equal to u dash plus v by 1 plus v by c square. Ux dash is nothing but u dash. Similarly, u dash from this equation it can be written as u dash equal to u minus v by 1 minus v by c square into u, 1 minus v by c square into u. This is mistakenly written as it is x, it is u, okay, it is u. Now we have to consider v equal to c and u dash equal to c. So if we have to consider v equal to c for this equation and u dash equal to c for this equation, so the numerator will be 2c divided by c. U dash is c, v equal to c by here v equal to c, u dash equal to c means it will be c square by c square will be 1 plus 1, so it will be 2c by 2 equal to c, so u will be equal to c. Okay, similarly, if you are going to be put u dash as c and v as c, you can get also u equal to c from this equation also. So you can see here that this is your u dash equal to v, u minus v by 1 minus v into u by c square, this one. So we have to consider that u dash equal to c and v equal to c. Put u dash as c and v, u minus v as c, 1 minus v we have to put as c into u by c square. So we can found c equal to u minus c by c got cancelled, 1 minus u by c. So it will be c equal to u by c whole divided by this will be c, if I am going to add it, it will be c minus u by c. So it can be written as c equal to this c gone to the numerator, c into u minus c by c minus u, c got cancelled, so it will be c minus u equal to u minus c, so hence u equal to c. So in this way we found that the velocity is not to be more than light speed. The same thing it is written, that this implies that if a ray of light is emitted in S dash frame that moves with a speed c relative to S frame also, then the speed of the light measured by the stationary observer in S frame is also c. Okay, so suppose a light, we have to consider that it is moving, this frame of reference is moving, this S dash is moving. One light is glown off, and this light, suppose this is the light, okay, so glown up and it is moved with velocity of c, and this observer who is sitting in S dash frame observed the speed of light is c, and also the observer who is sitting in S frame, that person also observed the speed of the light is c, because there is no upper limit of the speed of the light, or we can say a body or a particle could not be moved more than that of the speed of the light according to the relativity, special theory of relativity, and considering also relativistic addition of velocities. Okay, so next we have to do some problems by using this velocity of addition.